Imperial Congs, Translation Series Number 5. Unlike the Liangzhou culture site, where no jade working tool has been found, Otley Bayer has literally found thousands of nephrite tools here in Luzon. Bayer admits that he was puzzled by the abundance of nephrite artifacts in a land where no natural source of nephrite has yet been discovered. Otley Bayer came to the conclusion that the fully developed rectangular adze culture seems to have first entered Luzon in the Batangas area about the middle of the latter half of the 2nd millennium BC, being carried by a people, coming probably from South China or Indochina, much addicted to the use of nephrite as the chief material for their stone artifacts. They either brought a large supply with them or found some local source for the material, not since rediscovered. The superior skill and quality of jade crafts in the Zhou dynasty has not been matched by any other period. Who were these amazing craftsmen, and where did they disappear to? Perhaps they have not been recognized because there is no historical narrative to explain their presence on our islands. As we come to our final video on the Imperial Kong translation series, we hope that this may serve to help revive our missing memories of the past. Bird Kong B, Fish Kong, and Spirit Beast Kong translation, part 2, may be found in the Analects, Yao Ye, 1-2. Sons of the Expansion ask regarding the Great Opening. This may refer to those who have migrated to the newly opened lands and their children who may have been born in the colonies. Delays in what they hope to achieve by this time may have caused them to ask for advice. The son says, "How do you suppose? This is possible by means of going through government affairs." The son says, "Treasure the 5 pleasing things. Get rid of the 4 evil things. This may be done through government affairs." Sons of the Expansion say, "What do you mean by 5 pleasing things?" The son says, "When the sovereign is kind but not wasteful, when he requires hard work but is not resented, when he has desires but is not greedy, when he is superior yet not arrogant, when he is powerful but not cruel." Sons of Expansion ask, "What does it mean to be kind but not wasteful?" The son says, "Because when rulers place on subjects benefits that are good for them, is this not also kindness, yet not wastefulness? When rulers choose suitable labors, then again, who would resent the work? When the ruler's desires are virtuous and good things are attained, then again, who would call it greed? Whether with multitudes or alone, whether matters are big or small, the sovereign dare not take it easy. Is this not superiority, yet not arrogance?" These 3 Imperial Kong seem to be focusing on the positive aspects of leadership that the emperor wants to implement in his official ministers. Well thought of and carefully worded, these imperial councils remain applicable to leaders today. The sovereign correctly positions his honorable clothes and hat. Those who see him respect him as a dignified person. A poem from the Xi Qing describes the official black robes and hat worn by the imperial ministers of the court when they were on duty, a traditional costume still worn by Chinese bureaucrats just a few hundred years ago. A jade artifact found in the Philippines shows an ancient Chinese minister in his official black robes and hat. The brilliant craftsmanship of this Chinese official is showcased in natural layers of black and white jade, carved in Western Zhou Dynasty big slant method. Why are we finding these things in the Philippines? Perhaps it is time for us to rethink history. An inscription in Fort Santiago attributed to the Philippine national hero Jose Rizal says, "To foretell the destiny of a nation, it is necessary to open the book that tells of her past." Thank you for joining us in opening the book of the past in hopes for a brighter future.